Yes, and it was a good weekend at homecoming. We had the opportunity to celebrate five different championships, teams coming back. It was a great atmosphere, and about 10,000 plus folks in the stands. And we got off to a very, very good start. Lost a toss, and our offense went down the field. Kicked a field goal to go on top, which is great. And we really had some real good offensive defense in the first half, shut them down back and forth. We ended up hitting on a big pass play to B.C. Owens. We did the tush push down by the goal line and fourth and one, went in to make that 10-0, which everything's rolling nice and smooth. The irony of the game was that, you know, where we had been so pass heavy for the past, you know, 6-7 weeks, it was the run game that really took it. Aiden saying only threw for under 100 yards, was 6 of 9, very, very modest stats, hit some big plays. But our freshman tailback, Malachi Hosley, had a career day. On the day, he set Penn's all-time yards from scrimmage play in a 96-yard run as the ball was backed up, and had another 67-yarder. Rushed on the day for 260-plus yards. Had a fantastic day, and it was real, real special because, again, that was one of the areas that we had not been excelling in, and thankfully for the help of the offensive line, good vision, and a great job by Aiden and the offensive staff by getting us to check into certain sets and formations for those opportunities that come for the young pup, which he did a great job. Kind of interesting on his long run, I guess the first 67-yarder came first, and he broke through. He made the corner miss and man-to-man and took it. And as he's running to the Jumbotron, he got a chance. He could see a buddy behind him, which is great. So he scores that touchdown. And I don't realize until I'm in the press conference, but he took a zone play to the right, clogged up. He broke it back to the left, put his foot in the ground, and took off. But their corner was hot and heavy on him. And he's watching the Jumbotron close. And at the 10-yard line, he makes a break to the right. And people saying, does he have eyes in the back of his head? No, he was watching himself on the Jumbotron run the whole time. So, obviously, you know, great opportunity there. But, you know, the defense, it was interesting. So we got to halftime winning 16-0. They blocked our extra point, came on out, and they went down and they scored right away. It's like, okay, here we go. You can feel the tide turning. I'll get the ball out back again, 3 and out. We punt. They're driving the ball again, back down and deep. Third down and short, we stopped them. They go to kick a field goal, and Travis McFarland blocks the extra point, the field goal. It goes down to the 8-yard line. We then get a personal foul taunting. Ball gets marched back down to the 6-yard line, and the first play from scrimmage, we take it 96 yards, which is huge. We get then late in the fourth quarter, okay? They're driving again to try to cut it to a one-score game, and they end up getting it first and goal on our 2-yard line, and in four plays, we stopped them as they went for it on fourth. So huge, huge play by both offense and defense on the day, and special teams kept everything pretty much in check. So that was a lot of fun with that victory, which, again, as we've said all along, just let's be 1-0 there, which sets us to head up to Boston this weekend to play a very, very good Harvard team who, again, as we know, only has one loss in the league. This for us, you know, as we've said all along, this is our playoffs, so we have to go up there and perform well. We've had, you know, good practices Monday through Wednesday so far, and the kids are focused. And they know what's at stake, and obviously everybody's got that sense of readiness. Health is always important, and fortunately at this point in time, we are relatively healthy in all of our key positions there, and just got to get to the starting line to get through the rest of this week's in practice. They're a talented team. They have run the ball well with a running quarterback, and they've swapped out quarterbacks this week, so a little bit on offense, but they've been scoring 30-plus points a game. Their defense is typical, is very, very, very stout. It'll be their senior game, last game, and everything else, and it's always a treat to head up to Cambridge this time of year. So our kids are excited, and we got a pretty good track record playing up north, so I'm looking forward to it. Questions? Well, I'm not sure he thought he could use it. The first time with the new scoreboard, the first time him really maybe running in that direction. Yeah, he talented. And it's been a journey because we didn't like ordain not you know, put him as the first team running back from the start of camp. He's had to earn it. A couple of guys got dinged up, whatever it may be, and took the most of his opportunities. But he's very, very gifted. As we have a lot of tailbacks that are gifted, but he showed that extra burst that you're looking for. And I think we always see that running back who can get you that 3, the 10, 15-yard gain. It's that one that's special that can make you make that last guy miss either by running over him or around him. And, you know, Malachi's got that gift and ability, both running the ball and catching the ball. Yeah, well, we started that first thing Monday morning because, again, we want to take it one game at a time. And remember this, last year we were in a very similar situation where we had lost to Harvard in week 9, okay, and we had to go up to Princeton and beat them on the last play to have a shot for it. We needed Harvard to win the last game, which they did not do, and Yale beat them. So our kids know it. They understand it. And again, without having a playoff situation as Villanova and other schools have, this is what our kids play for. To get to be in this position to do it, so they get it. But the young kids, they have to learn it, that process.
Excuse me. Earlier in the season, you had talked about how your short pass game was kind of an extension of the running game. Now that you add Malachi to that mix, how much more potent does it make your offense?
Yeah, I say this. I think what our offensive staff does a tremendous job of. Okay, is making a plan that fits not only our kids and what their capabilities are, but how to attack an opponent. Okay, I mean, that's the key to offensive play. I mean, being a defensive coach, if they're going to give you the hitch all the way down the field, why not just take it? If they're going to load the box, if they spread it on out, let's get the opportunity to run. So I think that sort of ability to really be grounded, you're not just always after that 300-plus-yard passing game because it's great for a stat line. No, it's do what you need to do to win. I think that is sort of the mark of quality coaches and obviously then players buying into it. And it's still extensive a run. The problem last week, we knew that the style of defense that that Cornell was playing, that those hitches and the bubbles were not going to be there. We knew that. We knew we could crease some of the runs, and we knew we could take the shots over the top. But their style, what they did out front, double eagle, cut corners, really trapped all the running game, the quick passing game that you're normally used to. And we then were able to exploit it the other way. So now the fact that we had those weapons and then that stuff there, I will let you know that there are 5 other guys that help you out with that, and that's called offensive linemen at tight ends. So it was just him running the ball. Those guys did a nice job of blocking and doing that stuff. And that's going to be the big challenge this week. Harvard's got a very, very good defensive line. Their nose guard is 6'2", 320, and he is a disruptor in the middle. He just sits there as a wrecking ball, just messes everything up. So we'll have our hands full with that.
Kelsey and Hurts are a unique player. How similar is your
team? It is similar to that. I mean, what we do is we bring in our 3 defensive linemen, okay, who are all roughly about 300 pounds. We sit there behind not Aiden. We bring in Liam O'Brien, our backup quarterback, in, who's got some good savviness. Not that Aiden couldn't do it, but there, and they do the shove pretty well, and it's been effective with us. In I think Liam's got 5 touchdowns, and at least 4 of them are on that play. Which, again, we were only a half a yard, and think about it. Okay, snap the ball back 4 yards in the shotgun, only to run 5 yards up. If you can do and take advantage of that stuff, why not? Why not do that? Pretty soon it's getting outlawed, so we might as well do it now while it's still legal.
You got to play where you end up with a D lineman around the end now.
We always have a little bit of trickery in that stuff. And matter of fact, our guy back in the middle, okay, Michael Morris, actually played running back in high school. Okay, now he's also 280 pounds right now, a little different than high school, but he's got ability to do some things and catch the ball. So those kids are always want to build to that. But with that, any questions? Well, Coach Juan, congratulations again. Great, great career. And I'm not sure if folks know this, but he is taking a new post of head of officials. Okay. So you will see him on a different light, seeing all the complaints coming in and the assignments. He's maybe refereeing a couple games next year, but we'll see him there. Good. Best of luck, Coach.